Hello and welcome to the Buffalo Wings Roller Hockey YouTube channel. Up until now, we've concentrated on highlight videos edited to background music, but today we are unveiling our brand new Game of the Week feature, complete with pre- and post-game interviews, stats, and more. This week's matchup features two 4-1 teams from our Tuesday Copper Division, Chuck Norris versus the Manglers. Here is Buffalo Wings reporter Chris Gump with Matt Stottlemyre from Chuck Norris.
All right, everyone. I'm Chris Gump here, the newest reporter for the Buffalo Wings. I'm here with Matt Stottlemyre from our Tuesday Bronze opponent tonight, Chuck Norris. I play for the Manglers. It's a big showdown in the standings. It should be a very competitive game. And we just wanted to get Matt's thoughts on what he thinks the keys to the game will be tonight.
With both teams being 4-1, I mean, I see it as being a very evenly matched game. I feel as though if I can avoid Gump's heavy stick here and get some shots on Brucey, it's going to be game over. But then again, we'll see from there.
All right. Well, it seems you may have the mental edge over us. we'll see how the physical aspect comes into play. Speaking of, you know, getting shots through, how have you guys been doing offensively this year? I know historically you're more of a defensive team. Who's been one of the major contributors on offense this season so far?
Still defensive as usual. Nothing's really changed. Our scoring hasn't been that high. Our defense has been pretty good. As far as offense go, myself and my brother have been carrying the load for the most part. We get a couple sneakers in the back door from Eric Reeves, but that's really about it. So we assume a low-scoring score, maybe 6-5, 7-6 maybe for a final score today.
Well, 7-6 would be a little high, especially for us. I mean, you know, we are almost kind of leading the league in goals against. But there you have it from Matt Stottlemyre himself. Keys to the game and what he thinks it's going to take tonight. So that'll wrap it up with Matt. Thanks a lot.
Thanks for having me.
Chris was also able to chat with Bruce Kosmoski, goaltender for the Manglers. Here he is with Bruce's take on tonight's matchup.
All right, Chris Gump back here for the Buffalo Wings. We got the game of the week tonight in the Tuesday Copper Division. The 4-1 Manglers going up against the 4-1 Chuck Norris squad. Should be a really intense battle. We're here with the goaltender from the Manglers, Bruce Kosmoski. Come on in, Bruce.
How's it going, Gump?
Doing good. So I just talked with Matt Stottlemyre and got his keys to the game and wanted to get the same from you. What do you think it's going to take to get the win tonight?
It's going to take hard work, good team effort. We're going to have to battle hard out there. There's a lot of key factors. Our team needs to play pretty strong to win this game, I think.
Yeah, I think it's going to take a strong defensive presence to match theirs. They do tend to have a very formative defensive presence in their own end. They probably like to break out the puck, get some quick shots, but make sure they're always responsible in their own end. But we've been pretty responsible ourselves this season. We got a pretty low goals against, and it's a pretty good credit to you. What do you think have been some of the keys to keeping our goals against average down so low?
You know, just good defense, you know, having my natural abilities, you know, help me out in that goal crease there. Just got to stop the puck, you know.
You got it. Well, it sounds like it's going to be a pretty defensive tilt tonight, and hopefully we have what it takes to bring it home. But if we lose, it's to a worthy opponent.
Well, I don't think we'll be doing losing out there. You know, there's three things that are going to take to win this game for us. Number one, every time the Manglers go on the rink, we go to war. We don't just play the game, we go to war to win. This is number two. And number three is we got to have fun out there. Right, Tom?
That's right. It's always about fun. So for this week, Game of the Week, this is Chris Gump reporting, and we'll see you next week.
We'll pick things up in the first period. Manglers on the attack. Chris Gump leaves it for John Brown, who brings it up through center. He finds Jason Flowers' back door, buries a shot for a 1-0 Manglers lead. Just over a minute and a half later, Mark Chafee makes the defensive play. He passes it up to Jason Flowers, who starts off on a 2-on-2 with John Brown. Flowers finds Brown backdoor again, and the Manglers take a 2-0 lead. Chuck Norris answers quickly, Matt Stottlemyre with the steal. He comes out of the corner with the puck and cuts the Mangler lead to 2-1. Closing minutes of the first period, Eric Reed for Chuck Norris takes a shot. It gets blocked by Chris Gump of the Manglers. The Manglers will get their share of blocked shots because their team is entirely made up of current or former goaltenders. But John Brown brings the puck back. He misses high. Jason Flowers goes into the corner to recover it. Cuts to the slot. Lets the wrist shot go. and gives the Manglers a 3-1 lead to end the first period. Early second period, Manglers on the power play and getting some good puck movement as Jason Flowers fakes a shot and John Brown crosses it to Chris Gump to give the Manglers a 4-1 lead, and it looks like they may pull away. Chuck Norris would begin him on a comeback though as Matt Sotomayor picks up the puck in his own end. He goes the length of the floor with it and is able to find Josh Wendt for the easy tap in to cut the Manglers' lead to 4-2. Minutes later, Wendt and Stoudemire would hook up again. This time it's Stoudemire who takes Wendt's pass and pulls Chuck Norris to within a goal, beating Kosmoski on his stick side high. Tempers would start to flare as the game got closer. Mark Chafee and Paul Stoudemire battling in the corner would both be sent off after this shoving match. But Stoudemire would get the extra two and send the Manglers back on the power play, leading 4-3 with 5 minutes left in the second period. Matt Stoudemire would again take the game in his own hands, scoring this shorthanded goal to knot it up at 4-all going into the third period. Chuck Norris grabbed their first lead of the game as Stoudemire gets his fourth of the game on another stick side wrist shot. But the Manglers would deadlock the game again as Flowers completed his hat trick off of a nice feed from Werner and some good work by John Brown in the corner. Soon after tying the game, the Manglers would grab the lead again as Brown nets his second of the game. 6-5 Manglers with about 10 minutes left in the third period. Four and a half minutes left in the third. Kosmoski with the huge save on Stoudemire, and Gump tries to send Flowers on a breakaway. Reeves would pick it off though, and Paul Stoudemire would connect with brother Matt on the deflection to tie it up for Chuck Norris at 6. Another quick goal for Chuck Norris gives them the lead for good, when Reeves hammers home the rebound of Paul Stoudemire's slap shot. The Manglers would have one last chance to tie it, as Brown picks off the clearing attempt and beats Flowers alone in front. But he fans on the return pass attempt, and Gump fails to connect on the rebound, as Chuck Norris kills off the final 13 seconds to take the first game of the week 7-6 over the Manglers. After a back-and-forth third period, Chuck Norris remains atop of the Tuesday Copper Division, led by Matt Stoudemire and his 5 goals to a 7-6 victory over the Manglers. Let's hear what a few key players had to say after the game.
It was a hard-fought match, you know. There's a better team.
Win some, you lose some.
What about the opportunities you guys had late to tie the game?
You know,
should have shot.
Sometimes you win, sometimes you lose. We had fun.
Did I not predict 7-6 for the final of the game?
I don't know. We'll have to go back and check the previous interview.
Mark these words. I said 7-6.
So anyway, that was a pretty close game there. 7-6.
No, it would be.
Describe it. What happened on the play?
I'll describe that cross pass.
You put it on net. Pick the play down. Slam it home. That's what Chuck Norris does.
That'll wrap it up for our first edition of Buffalo Wings Roller Hockey Game of the Week. Stay tuned for future installments. And remember, you can always purchase full-length game DVDs or highlight packages. Just contact any Wings staffer for more information. Thanks for watching.